medical attire and personal protective equipment. Identifies clothing items specified as personal protective equipment. So lab coat, gloves, mask, and glasses with side shields. Identifies when clinic attire should be worn. So anytime you're in the treatment or sterilization area, and gloves, glasses, or masks should not be worn outside of the treatment area. Identifies the protocol for transport and laundering of personal protective equipment. So shoes should not be worn outside of the UCDH clinic, including into the classroom. And lab coats should be turned inside out, placed in a plastic bag, and taken home and laundered separately from other garments with bleach. Identifies and demonstrates proper clinic hairstyles. So hair must be worn off the shoulders, and it should be fastened back away from the face. Hair should never hang into the operator's eyes. Facial hair is not allowed, and you must wear solid surface disinfectable hair accessories. Identifies and demonstrates proper lab coat use and wear. So we need a clean, new, unwrinkled lab coat each day. It should be fastened at the neck, buttoned all the way down, and should cover the knees. Gloves should always cover your cuffs, and you should never place gloved hands into your pockets. And the lab coat should never be worn into the restroom. Identifies and demonstrates proper clinical socks and shoes, or appropriate clinical socks and shoes. So we should have long white socks that cover the ankle, and no skin should show when we're sitting down. And we should wear white shoes with white non-marking soles and closed toes. Identifies and demonstrates the proper use and wear and removal of a face mask. So a face mask should be placed before your gloves and glasses. It should be used in every intraoral procedure. It should be placed over your nose and your mouth, and it should never be worn underneath your chin like this. The face mask should be changed anytime it becomes soiled or moist, or in between patients. When removing the face mask, you should always remove it by the side loops in the back, never by grabbing the front of the mask. Identifies and demonstrates the proper use of operator protective eyewear. So we want to wear eyewear, we place it after the mask and before the gloves. It must be worn in all intraoral procedures as well. It should have a really wide coverage, including side shields, to avoid splatter in the eyes. Patients should also be provided with the same protective eyewear. It should also be worn by them during any intraoral procedure except the exposure of radiographs. And then we're going to identify the proper cleaning of patient and operator eyewear. So these glasses will be cleaned with soap and water in between each patient and at the end of each clinic day. Identifies and demonstrates proper hand care protocol. So you should always have clean, smoothly trimmed, short fingernails with no polish, and jewelry is not allowed. And then demonstrates the proper pre and post clinic hand washing, which is the antiseptic wash. So I will be washing my hands for 30 seconds, and this should be repeated 3 times each. So for this video today, I will just be doing the 1 30-second wash. When you do your PE, you will have to repeat that 3 times, but I am making sure to concentrate on the back of the hands, the interdigital areas, the thumbs, and wrists, and fingernail areas.
You can't see it, but she's looking at the clock to make sure it's been 30 seconds.
Keep washing. And then we'll just rinse. In a downward motion, making sure not to touch the side of the sink. Okay, so I'm going to grab 2 paper towels and dry my hands really well so my gloves will fit. So I'm leaving the water running while I do this, and then I will use this same paper towel to touch the faucet to turn off the water. And then I will immediately throw this away and then don my gloves before touching anything else. We'll go ahead and put these on. And then I will identify the between patient hand washing which is the routine hand wash. And that is just using soap and water for 15 seconds in between each patient, or using hand sanitizing rub, rubbing it for 15 seconds until it is dry. I will identify the protocol for glove use, but make sure these are over our cuffs. So gloves need to be worn anytime in clinic when you're doing setup, cleanup, anytime you're in an intraoral environment, or if you're handling sterile instruments. And then I will identify the protocol for leaving the intraoral environment or operatory. So anytime I'm doing that, I will remove my gloves, hand sanitize or wash, and then when I come back to the operatory or intraoral environment, I will always hand sanitize or wash and then put my gloves back on. And then I will identify the post-glove removal hand washing. So I will take my gloves off and immediately wash my hands. And then I will identify the protocol for damage or defective gloves. So if they have a damage or a defect, I will immediately take my gloves off, rewash my hands, and then place new gloves. And now I will identify and demonstrate degloving, proper degloving, without contaminating my hands. So with my left fingers, I will pinch a couple inches up on my right glove and then pull this until a clean part of the glove is exposed down there. Then with my right hand, I will remove my left glove without touching my hand and making sure to ball this up into this right glove already. Then with my left hand, I will touch this clean part of the glove and I will invert it as I'm putting the other glove inside that one. Then we will immediately throw these away and we will immediately hand sanitize or wash our hands before touching anything else.